Hello, my name is Arthur Stein. I have a background in electronics and as an installation artist at the Art Academy from Holland. And here at the Royal Academy, I'm an assistant professor teaching motion graphics, interaction design at the Institute for Visual Design.
And my name is Jakob Jung Wille. I have a background as dramaturg and somebody who works with the design of stories. And I'm an associate professor here at the Academy.
Some months ago, Jakob and I decided to opt for a project which has some funding, and we decided to call the project Flash Forward, since it is dealing with future scenarios.
Yes, I think when most people think of design, they think of design as problem solving or giving beautiful shapes to something useful. But you could also think of design as that you imagine something that doesn't exist and then give it shape. And in that sense, design resembles fiction. When you work with fiction, you work with your imagination and then give it narrative shape. And in some kinds of fiction, you might imagine flying underneath the water or examining space in spaceships. And then you work with science fiction. And in science fiction, design is an important ingredient. So we try to turn that around and say sometimes fiction is an important ingredient in design as well. And that's design fiction. So in this project, we ask the students to imagine future story worlds and then design prototypes for that future world. Not as something that necessarily solved any problem, but a way to think about present problems and future solutions in an artistic way. So that's what Flash Forward is about.
We decided upon making an exhibition together with the students, third semester candidates on graphical communication design, who worked in groups. And this exhibition should show, demonstrate their ideas through prototypes, which ended as future scenarios. And for that we had two ingredients. One was interaction, and the other one is actually images in motion, images over time. That were then shown as an exhibition that was accessible for an audience.
Yes, we asked the students to think about what worried them right now, as for instance the corona crisis or the crisis of our democracies or the ecological crisis of the earth. And I think the results were quite surprising. When Arthur and I were kids or younger in the 80s, we were faced with serious problems as the possible nuclear war. And no future was our motto. And we, in a way, romanticized the darkness of that age. The students here worked in a different way and addressed the problems facing them with poetry and humor, and I think that might be a better strategy. And there's hope for us then.
Flash Forward was a three-week workshop where the first week was an intensive input for the students with a lot of tools but also a lot of lectures.
Yeah, we worked with some different artists, Kirsten Astrup, who's a visual artist, and Natalie Körner, who's has an artistic development project here at the Academy.
And also Jakob Torbeck from Space and Time, who is a graphic designer and makes a lot of large-scale interactive installations, and Mika Voleur, who is a writer who writes for interactive media and also for artistic productions.
In the project, we also worked with the Danish Design Center and Oscar Stockholm, who is working with the future scenarios at the Design Center.
One of the reasons that we work in this field is that by kind of using storytelling and scenarios, we can kind of get that very instinctive and emotional experience of being in different kinds of futures, and it can kind of unlock some very interesting dialogues and in discussions here in the present, because it really shows just how different the future can play out. And that creates kind of like a very big and vast opportunity space that we can claim and use and kind of work within. I think one of the things that was the most surprising for me, kind of seeing the stuff that the students had been making and the installations and the concept that they had developed, was just kind of like how tactile and diverse those projects were and kind of how complete they felt in just the matter of weeks that they had at their disposal. On one hand, you had like Hans Christian Andersen, like paper cuts with all these nature-inspired paper constructions and this cozy little apartment you could step into and kind of explore on your own. I think that was really dreamy and exciting. While just next to it, there was this kind of almost dystopian idea about an AI constructing itself out of waste in the ocean and kind of coming to life and scanning your emotions as you were kind of reaching out and touching things. I think that kind of contrast was really exciting. I mean, and then there was like the concept of like a climate catastrophe gym, and the idea that you could kind of, you know, work out and kind of prepare for the climate collapse was an exciting way to kind of frame some of the challenges that we're facing. I think all of the different concepts were exciting and brought different things forward and really showed in very different ways all the things that design and designers can bring to the table when we work with the future and try to kind of question the ways and the directions that we're moving in as a society. I think that was very powerful.
Also, our colleague Professor Ida Engholm was involved in the project, who came with very good input throughout the workshops.
Flash Forward is a brilliant example of how you can use design and fiction as a tool to imagine possible futures. It's not the usual sort of predicting or forecasting, spotting trends and extrapolating. The students here have posed what if questions that can provoke questions about what kind of future we want or not want. The exhibition, I think, is a very strong example of speculative design as social dreaming, including nightmares. But I think that both dreams and nightmares are necessary to make decisions about tomorrow.
All in all, we are very satisfied with the resulting exhibition, where we could see 9 projects that were very self-explanatory and had a high standard, both in graphical and in artistic expression. And interesting to see the students' take on a future that we do not know yet.
Okay, I think we can say that we feel really lucky that we had the opportunity to do this project, and that it was only possible through extra funding for artistic research. And I think we should do it again.
We will do it again.